was a bad start. Doubly blessed is the couple who enters into a marriage with the approval and the blessing of their family and friends. Who has the honor of presenting this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Welcome, friends and family. We want to welcome you to the mill at Fine Creek, where we've come together to celebrate these two wonderful individuals, Christopher and Stephanie. We're here today to act as witnesses as they join their lives, and we're here today to celebrate the best part of what it means to be human, the gift of love. Chris and Steph have always wanted an intimate wedding ceremony since the day they started discussing the possibility of marriage. And I want to emphasize this to all of you to point out how special you are to them. You were invited here to share in this moment because you are the people that mean the absolute most to them. The understanding and the mutual respect that they bring to their lives together had its roots in the love and guidance that you've given them. They are honored and very thankful that you took the time to travel to support them today. Chris and Steph, I also want you to take a second and turn out and look at this group, this amazing group of people who have come here to celebrate you and support you. A marriage needs the help of a community, of family and friends who will be there to stand beside you during your hard times and your happy times. And these are your people, the ones who have shared in your best and your worst days. And these are the ones that are going to be there for all of the amazing days ahead. Each of us here today will witness the words that these two will speak to one another and the vows that they'll make. And may we always do all within our power to support the union that will be made here today and to nurture the bond between these two people who we love so much. And then if we could all just take a few moments of silence to honor those who could not be with us today, but are certainly here in spirit. So before we get to the good stuff, like the rings and the kissing, let me introduce myself and talk to you a little bit about the ceremony. So for those that I haven't met yet, my name's Drew. I'm not a rented minister from the venue. I'm actually friends with these two. And I've known them each as individuals before they started dating. So I've gotten to kind of witness their relationship progress and blossom into what it is today. Truly, I admire these two for a lot of reasons. They are some of the craziest, best athletes at Orange Theory, for starters. But they're also two of the kindest, most authentic, and inspiring people that I know. So to say that officiating this wedding is an honor would be quite the understatement for me. Chris and Steph, thank you so much for trusting me and letting me be a part of your day. I am both humbled and extremely proud of you two.
Love you guys too.
I've been able to watch you guys grow in your relationship. And when you guys first started dating, you could tell things were a little bit different. Steph looked at Chris differently. She smiled and laughed. And most importantly, she was 110% her authentic self whenever he was around. You could tell he had a really deep respect for her as a human and a friend. And there is no stronger foundation for a relationship. It's been quite the ride leading up to this day. A journey of love, support for each other, of sporadic adventures to far-off places, of trying new things, failing, thriving, learning, and growing together, truly growing together. You guys have grown a lot as individuals and as a couple. You've excelled as professionals, created a home, built a community of friends and colleagues. But beyond that, you've developed a true respect, an unspoken trust, a simple and easy kindness towards one another, the ability to communicate well and to compromise, and the gift of laughter. If you've been around these two, you know there is no shortage of happiness and adventure. But the main thing that always stands out about Chris and Steph is that as they've grown in their relationship, it just gets easier and easier for them to love each other. They are an example that love can be lighthearted and simple. Don't get me wrong, they've put in their fair share of trials and tribulations. But instead of it wearing on them, their relationship continues to deepen and their love becomes more and more abundant. So with that, we're going to pause and we're going to have a reading by Stephen Lasky. If you'd like, there's a mic for you.
The Art of Marriage by Wilfred Peterson. The little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing the things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the creativity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner.
Thank you. I love that. Yeah, that's really good. So before we proceed with the rings and the vows, Chris and Steph have chosen to have you witness an untraditional tradition. So up here, I have a box. Inside the box, there's a bottle of wine, and then somewhere up here, there are love letters that Chris and Steph have written to each other. And the letters describe the good qualities that they see in one another and the reasons that they fell in love and that they're choosing to commit their lives to each other. They've given a lot of thought to these letters, and they've been sealed in individual envelopes, and neither has seen what the other has written. And then Chris and Steph, some of your loved ones, have also composed letters containing their thoughts, their love, and their most important pieces of advice for you as you journey through life together. So if you've written a letter to the couple, could you please come up and place it into the box now? There you go. So, Chris and Steph, should you ever find your marriage enduring serious hardship, as some marriages do, you are to, as a couple, open this box, sit and drink the wine together, and then separate and read the letters that were placed into this time capsule on your special day. By reading these letters, you will reflect upon the reasons that you fell in love and that you chose to marry each other. You will read the letters of love, support, and advice written by your loved ones, and you will share a new resolve to strengthen your relationships, your relationship. So the hope is, obviously, that they never open this box, right? And if that's the case, then you guys are to crack it and enjoy it on your 10th wedding celebration. So go ahead and seal the box. Okay.
Just a little dent. It's fine. It's fine. It's perfectly fine.
All right. So today's mostly an ordinary day, right? The earth is still rotating. The sun came up, kind of, just like it was supposed to. People slept in. Coffee was made. And Chris and Steph just happen to be getting married. But the not-so-ordinary part is how these two are making promises to each other for the rest of their days, no matter how ordinary or unusual those days may be. True love begins well before this wedding day, and all of the efforts of marriage and love are going to continue well beyond this ceremony's end. And today, Chris and Steph come together and submit that marriage is not an end, it's a beginning. It's not a perfect beginning. It's not a clean slate. It's a process. Marriage is growth. Marriage is a bold step into an unknown future. It's risking who we are for the sake of who we could be. That committing yourself to one person for life is not a rejection of freedom, but rather it means that you have the courage to risk falling in love. A love that has nothing to do with possession and everything to do with participation. Because in a marriage, you're promising to care about everything. The good, the bad, the terrible, the mundane, all of it, all the time, every day. You are saying, your life will not go unnoticed because I will notice it. Your life will not go unwitnessed because I will be your witness. So Chris and Steph, try to remember this, what I'm going to say. Be constantly grateful for the presence of this precious person who is choosing to make a life with you. Remember that. Make each other the recipient of daily kindness. The world can sometimes be a rough place, so be generous with your compliments. Be attentive, be helpful. Each of you can, by your tenderness towards each other and your kind words and your thoughtful actions, you can make your marriage and your home an uplifting refuge. Be intentional about prioritizing each other and your relationship. Just like you prioritize working out or golfing or fostering your friendships, don't forget to be intentional about focusing on your marriage and each other. Exercise and train the muscle of your relationship with focus. And don't put your relationship last like so many people do. And then last and most importantly, make truth the unfailing bedrock of your lives together. A happy, loving marriage is built upon trust and respect. And that trust and respect can only be sustained if you are both deeply committed to always being open and truthful in every single exchange, no matter how small. So before we move into the vows, I just want to remind us all that this is a rare opportunity, perhaps the only opportunity, that this particular group of family and friends will be together as one. So just take a minute, look around, savor this moment. Like all of life's most important moments, this is soon going to be a memory. And you've come here today, all of you out in the audience, you've come here today not just to enjoy a party, but to pledge your support to this couple, to say not only, yes, I'm here for your wedding, but yes, we're here for your marriage. We're here for you to offer you advice, give perspective, listen, and support your union through good and bad. And as we have pledged our support to you, now it's time for you to declare your support to each other. So Chris and Steph, the symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, hey, you know all those things that we promised and we hoped and we dreamed? Well, I actually meant it, every word. Before this moment, you've been a lot of things to one another. You've learned a lot from each other, but now you're going to say a few words that are going to take you across a threshold. So nothing's ever going to be quite the same. After these vows, you will say to the world, this is my most important person. So you're facing each other and you've joined hands. And I just want you to focus on your hands for a second. So these are the hands of your best friend of today and every day. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build your future together. These are the hands that will lovingly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you as you struggle through difficult times. And these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours. My wish for you in this moment is that you try to clear your heads and try to remember each and every word and cherish this memory and enter into your vows with conviction and your hearts wide open. So, Chris, you're going to go first. Just repeat after me.
Got it.
I, Christopher. Take you, Stephanie.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and health.
Until death do us part.
And then Stephanie, repeat after me. Okay. I, Stephanie, take you, Christopher.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and health. Until death do us part. May we please have the rings. He wants to be a groomsman. Okay. You good?
Yep.
Okay. I can hold him if you want. You're going to use them soon. It's okay. Wedding bands are a visible, tangible symbol.
It's okay.
You can get them. It's okay.
Yeah, hold them right there.
We love dogs. Okay. Wedding bands are a visible, tangible symbol of a couple's commitment. And many people talk about rings as being this perfect circle that has no beginning and no end. But we all know rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth. Metals are liquefied in a furnace at 1,000 degrees. I promise I have a point here. The hot metal is forged, cooled, and polished. And something beautiful is made from raw elements. And love is just like that. Love comes from humble beginnings that are made by imperfect beings. And it's the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. So Chris and Steph, let these rings serve as a reminder of the feelings that you have in your heart at this very moment. And as you look at your wedding band, remember the great gift that you've been given and all that you have in one another. Remember that you have someone to share this life with. Never again will you walk alone. So Chris, you're going to go first, so grab Steph's ring. Steph, will you love, support, and challenge me? And be my closest friend. Confidant. And companion. Say I will.
I will.
I give you this ring as a sign. That I choose you. To be my partner and best friend. Until the end of my days. Wear it.
Think of me.
And know.
That I love you.
Respect you.
And cherish you. It's good.
Okay. All right. Your turn to repeat after me. Chris, will you love, support, and challenge me? And be my closest friend, confidant, and companion.
Yes.
I give.
Good job.
Good.
All of you.
Of course. I said yes. Yeah.
I give you this ring as a sign.
I give you this ring as a sign.
That I choose you.
That I choose you.
To be my partner and best friend.
To be my partner and best friend.
Until the end of my days.
Until the end of my days.
Wear it, think of me, and know.
Wear it, think of me, and know.
That I love you, respect you, and cherish you.
That I love you, respect you, and cherish you.
You can put it on.
You did that good.
Good job. We're almost done.
Good.
Chris and Steph, you've made vows to one another, you've exchanged rings, you've received the blessing of this wonderful group of family and friends. So by the power vested in me by the great state of Virginia, it is my honor to pronounce you husband and wife. We can cheer. Woo! Don't kiss yet. Don't kiss yet. All right. So before we let them kiss, we're going to do something different. And I need all of you to participate or else it's weird because it'll be too quiet. So everyone's going to pronounce them in full voice, okay? So you're going to repeat after me. And if you don't do it loud enough, we have to do it again. So we, your family and friends.
We, your family and friends.
Now pronounce you married.
Now pronounce you married.
You may kiss the bride.
You may kiss the bride.
You guys are awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, I am honored and happy to announce for the first time as a married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Christopher Shaw. Love you guys. Congratulations.
We're out of here.